Hi guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. So from the title of the video, you already know that I'm going to be sharing my COVID story with you all. This is something that I hid from you guys for a really long time. Even when I had COVID, I did not really share this with you all because I didn't want anyone to get tense about me and I was really uncomfortable talking about it. Moreover, the energy levels were so low. So in the beginning of August, I was hit by COVID. Like me and my husband, we started getting the symptoms first, and we got ourselves tested and we both tested positive, and then the rest of the family members also started getting the symptoms and we all tested positive. So we were like quarantined in the house for like 18 days, not 14 but 18, just to be like sure all of the COVID symptoms are gone. During this entire time, it felt like house arrest. It's not easy to stay in the house for such a long time, but we kind of like managed, we kind of got through it, and I'm so glad the phase has finally passed. You have so much of weakness inside your body, and I don't know if it's the medicines or what, but it just makes you feel so sleepy. I literally did not feel like doing anything while I was, COVID positive. I literally just wanted to sleep all day, not eat anything. My taste buds were also not functioning well, and yeah, it was not a good place to be in. And not just during COVID, but even post COVID, the symptoms, the weakness, the drowsiness, all of that just carries forward even after COVID. Like my COVID period ended around, I think, by the mid of August, and even after that, like even till date, that's like 1 month post COVID, I still feel very sleepy. No matter how long I sleep, meri neend complete hi nahi hoti hai, and sometimes the weakness just kicks in. If I don't rest for a while, I have to lie down for at least like half an hour, like in the afternoon time. Otherwise, I feel very weak by the end of the day. So those things have been there even after COVID, and the worst of it all is hair loss. I don't know if it's the side effects of the medications of COVID or what, but hair fall itna zyada hota hai that it's actually turned into hair loss. Like, let me just show you. So can you see over here? There's a lot of hair thinning that has happened, and it's just the same on this side as well. And even if I do the middle partition, which I generally do, the partition has sort of widened a little bit. So a lot of hair fall, a lot of hair loss and thinning has basically happened, and I've been struggling with it for the past 1 month. I'm doing a lot of new things for my hair. I've changed my hair care routine a little bit, and I'm also eating a lot of other foods in my diet just to make sure that my hair remains healthy and the hair fall is like reduced. So I'm going to be sharing all of that with you in today's video. So firstly, I'm going to be talking about the hair care routine that I've been following. So I've been using this DIY hair oil, where I take 2 spoons of methi seeds and 2 spoons of kalonji, so the portions are equal, and I grind them in a mixture to turn them into a powder form. And to this, you can add some onion oil and a couple of other oils as well. I like to use this Wow Onion Black Seed Hair Oil. This contains a combination of onion and black seed oils, along with almond oil, castor oil, jojoba oil, olive oil, and coconut oil. I love the combination of oils in this bottle, and I mix it along with the powder that we just grinded. You want to mix it really well, and then let the powders infuse into the oil for at least 3 days. For 3 days, you want to keep this jar under sunlight for all of the ingredients to cook together. And after 3 days, you can apply this hair oil on your roots as well as on the lengths of your hair. You can either apply it just the way it is, or you can also strain it if you want. I like to use it just the way it is. I apply a good amount of the oil all over my scalp and massage it really well into my scalp for a while. I also like to take a little bit of the oil onto the lengths of my hair just to moisturize and nourish the lengths. I recommend you keep this hair oil on for at least 3 to 4 hours before washing it, so that all of the nutrients and all of the oil gets absorbed by your scalp and nourishes your scalp. And to wash my hair, I have now switched to an onion shampoo. The one that I've been using is by Wow. This is their red onion and black seed oil shampoo. And to follow it up, I've been using this same Wow Red Onion and Black Seed Oil Conditioner. The shampoo takes care of my hair fall while the conditioner takes care of hair breakage. I've always noticed that whenever I switch to onion based shampoos and conditioners, my hair fall reduces to half, and during this tough hair fall, hair loss time post COVID, this shampoo and conditioner combo is coming to my rescue. Onions are the best ingredients for hair fall, and I highly recommend you switch to onion based products if you're suffering through a lot of hair fall. The best part about these is that these are mostly made up of only natural ingredients. Like if you check the bottles, the shampoo is made up of 93% of naturally derived ingredients, whereas the conditioner is made up of 92% of naturally derived ingredients. So they are more than 90% naturally derived, and the rest 10% is preservatives and, you know, chemicals, but not bad chemicals, good chemicals. It's free from bad chemicals like parabens, mineral oil, silicone, color, etc. It doesn't contain any of those bad chemicals, but only good chemicals, things that are good for your hair. I've used a lot of onion products from a lot of brands, but this time I really did my research and picked the best ones. And even the black seed onion oil that I use in my DIY is 99.9% naturally derived. The rest 0.1% is the preservative that is used to preserve the quality and the shelf life of the product. But again, it's free from harmful chemicals like mineral oil, silicone, synthetic fragrance. It doesn't have any added fragrance, no added extra chemicals whatsoever. So extreme hair fall and hair loss post COVID is the reason why I selected this Wow Onion Wala range, and I'm so glad I did because my hair fall has literally become half in these 15 days. Hair loss bhi thoda sa kam ho raha hai is what I can see, and I'm pretty sure that if I keep following this hair care routine for a longer time, like very consistently, it's definitely gonna improve my hair situation a lot and, you know, stop the hair fall and hair loss that happened post COVID. Apart from changing my entire hair care routine, I've also started including a lot of foods in my diet which can help me with my hair health. So I like to soak 2 walnuts and 5 almonds in water overnight, and in the morning I peel off the skin of the almonds and consume the almonds and the walnuts on an empty stomach, along with 2 dates and 1 anjeer. I make it a point to consume all of this every single day in the morning. Also, I'm trying to balance my water intake. I'm trying to drink at least 4 liters of water every single day so that my body is hydrated and the acidity levels and everything is neutralized, and to make sure that my body doesn't generate a lot of heat because that also leads to a lot of hair loss. Apart from that, I'm waiting for the winter season to arrive because that's when you finally get fresh amla in the market. So I really want to consume fresh amla rather than the amla that is available throughout the year. Amla also helps you a lot with your hair fall issues, so I've been waiting for the winter season to come. So these are all of the things that I have started doing for my hair loss, and I've literally seen the hair loss, the hair fall cut into half ever since I started following this routine. Like obviously after a couple of days of starting to follow the routine, but the hair care routine I make it a point to follow twice a week, and the foods that I'm consuming I make it a point to consume every single day. Apart from that, you can also consume a lot of rich protein rich food like paneer or peanuts or soya, you know, anything that's rich in protein, you can also consume that for your hair health. And try to avoid as much junk food as possible because post COVID your body does become a lot weaker, and you need to like supply a lot of nutrients, a lot of goodness to your body, and junk food is obviously not going to provide that. It's only going to like thrash your body even more. So make sure that you eat good food post COVID, at least for a couple of months, and try to avoid junk as much as possible so that your body gets the essential nutrients, so that your body supplies these nutrients to your hair and your hair becomes stronger and the hair fall reduces. So you want to do all of this, and you know, the combination of a healthy diet and a good hair care routine is going to help you achieve your hair care goals, and it's going to help you to like reduce your hair fall. That's the exact thing that I've been doing for my hair fall, and I have seen a difference. So this is the hair care routine that I've been following. This is how I've been dealing with post-COVID hair loss. Obviously it's very very stressful, it's very I don't know what to call it, it's very depressing when you see, you know, so much of hair falling off, like especially after washing. But if you take good care of your health and good care of your hair, it's definitely going to improve. It's definitely going to improve with time. So you have to give it a little bit of time. You have to be patient and you have to be very consistent with what you're doing for yourself. So make sure that you like, you know, stay positive, keep doing these things and you're definitely going to see a difference. Hair fall to hona hi hai, agar like post COVID hair fall, if it's actually a thing, like it happened to me, I've heard a lot of people say that, you know, post COVID hair fall is a thing, but if it's actually a thing, it's gonna happen to everyone. So if it does happen, do not be disheartened, do not like take a lot of stress. It's just a phase that's gonna go away, and if you take good care of your hair and your health, it's gonna go away even faster. So yeah, that's all that I wanted to share about my post-COVID hair fall experience. To purchase any of the products that I mentioned in today's video, you can check out the description box for all of the links. They are all available on Amazon, Nykaa, Flipkart, on Wow's website, on Wow's app. The link to Wow app is also mentioned in the description box below. And in case if you purchase any Wow product, then make sure that you scan the QR code at the back of the packaging to ensure that your Wow product is 100% original and authentic. So yeah, with that I'm gonna wrap up this entire video. If there's something that you've been doing for your post-COVID hair loss or just in general for your hair loss, then do let me know in the comments below. I would love to try out more things to, you know, stop the situation as fast as possible and to improve it. Also, if you try out any of the things that I mentioned in today's video, then do let me know in the comments below. I would love to know your experience. And also, if you're new to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and also follow me on Instagram. And if you found this video helpful, then please also hit the like button. And yeah, with that, it's a wrap for today. I shall see you in my next video.